So the government and the regulations are happy for the moment to have the startups being funded whatever the way, and if the startup is raising money and developing and making big bucks, at some point there will be taxes on it, and it's everyone will be happy. And those startups intend to disrupt the big companies, banks, or providers of trust. This is all good because this is business against business. Natural. What about the aspect of disrupting the governments and not going as far as the crypto anarchists, but there is some part of it. And for that, the government may ignore them in the beginning, but at some point, maybe there will be some reaction. What do you think?
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's one aspect that's being talked about is governments being on the blockchain. And there's a company called BitNation, and their software is to enable an entire government to run on the blockchain with voting and rights and land registry and all of the above that you can think about. But we are still not very good at doing governance on the blockchain. So governance, decentralization has many layers. We are good at doing decentralization at the technical level, like doing file sharing and now cloud computing sharing, and other resources, and we are good at now getting better at business process decentralization, like getting attention to be aggregated or getting data to be aggregated. But the third level is decentralization at the governance level. We're not even good at doing governance on technology. Like, look at the DAO fiasco, that decentralized autonomous organization, which was a model of running an autonomous organization on Ethereum that crashed because of a software bug last year. And it's because we're not good at it yet. So before we can run, we have to walk a little bit. So I think we're going to see more attempts of mini governments or mini government entities. I don't think it's going to disrupt the existing governments. It's going to be more, initially at least, new types of governance experiments. I would like to see more governance experiments. I mean, Estonia is doing that, where they are granting a e-citizenship to anybody. Anybody in the world could become a citizen of Estonia on the blockchain, though. So you can go and get married there on the blockchain. You're not getting married in Estonia. You're getting married on the blockchain, but Estonia as a government just is facilitating the service. So they make money because then if you want to register your getting married, then they take a piece of that. So these are interesting experiments, and I'd like to see more. Voting, obviously, is potentially one application that governments are looking at, and it would be great to one day be able to not go anywhere and vote from wherever you are. Maybe they will have 90% voting instead of 60% or something like that.